Hey friends, hope you're well. We can now finally set up Apple Intelligence Beta in the latest iOS 18.1 update. Having tested it for a week, I think it's safe to say that this is absolutely a big software upgrade that will change the way that you use your iPhone. So in this video, I'll cover how to set up Apple Intelligence, the new AI features that I found most useful, and my thoughts and experience using Apple Intelligence day to day. So the very first thing you want to do to set up Apple Intelligence is head into Settings and then tap General, and then go into Software Update. And then from here, just make sure you've downloaded the latest iOS 18 update. So once your phone is updated to the latest iOS 18.1 or newer, go back to Settings, and then scroll down and you'll see a new Apple Intelligence and Siri option. So click into that. So over here, it's really important that you first switch the language to English and United States specifically, because currently Apple Intelligence only supports United States English and new language support is still a while away. Then go back and then toggle on Apple Intelligence right here. And then some prompts will pop up on screen. And obviously it's not popping up for me because I've already set it up. Now that it's activated, there's a couple of ways to bring up Apple Intelligence. The first one is by saying, of course, "Hey Siri." The edges of the display will now glow that trademark rainbow gradient. And the other way, let's cancel that. The other way is to double tap the bottom of the screen. And this will bring up the type to Siri function if you prefer not to speak. I've personally been typing to Siri over the last week more than I've been speaking. Maybe it's just become a habit for me. But now that we have Apple Intelligence properly set up, let's get stuck into the setup and features. The first feature is one of the more useful ones, and that's call recording. You'll need to make sure that these settings are switched on by going into Settings and then scroll down to Apps and then all the way to Phone. And here there is a new call recording option. Toggle this on and then go back, scroll to the top and just tap Apple Intelligence and Siri. Just make sure that all of these options are toggled on as well. Now, when you're on a call like this, there'll be a record button on the top left-hand corner, and everyone on the call will hear a "this call will be recorded" message. So, you know, no creepy secretive recording here. Once you're done with the call, it will save the call into the Notes app just like this here. And this is where you can listen back to it, get a full transcript of the entire call, and you can even get it summarized right here. Just tap Summary. And I found these summaries to be actually really accurate and a great way to get a single paragraph cliff note for long calls. This is a really great feature that's genuinely useful for important calls or if you just want to automatically share the summarized notes with someone. The next Apple Intelligence feature worth setting up is reduced interruptions, which is a new AI-powered focus mode. So from Settings, scroll down to Focus, and then tap the new Reduce Interruptions mode, and then make sure it's enabled here. Now on the home screen, if you hold down on the focus mode, you can now switch on the Reduce Interruptions mode, and this will intelligently show you what it believes is most important in terms of notifications that need your attention and filters out everything else. This is a great mode if, let's say, you know, you're working and you don't want to be distracted, but you're waiting on an important message or app notification to come through. This is a great focus mode for that. Next is improved Siri 2.0, and this is surprisingly a significant change. It's been updated in a few ways, like adding natural language so we can speak to it like we would with any other human. And the result Siri provides is just so much more useful during my tests in the last week. For example, previously, if I asked it to convert metrics for me, it'd usually say something like, "Here's what I found on the web," without actually telling me the answer. Now, if I ask, "Hey Siri, how fast is 100 kilometers an hour in miles per hour?" There we go. Siri finally gives us the actual answer and doesn't just send us to our website. It can now also reliably execute requests by itself, like, for example, "Hey Siri, play Coldplay songs on Spotify." And right there, it's immediately playing. Previously, it wouldn't even be able to do this, so it's pretty clear that Siri is getting overhauled. Over the week, I definitely began to use Siri a lot more than I previously would, which was basically never. and it should technically only get better with the upcoming ChatGPT 4.0 integration that's planned for Siri. Now, natural language search lets you bring up the exact photo you're trying to find right away, rather than searching one image at a time in the Photos app. So in the Photos app, tapping search, let's say I'm trying to find a photo like Jeff next to the white car on the highway. And you can immediately see that it picks out the correct photo, and it's just the one specific photo that I wanted. And Apple Intelligence does a great job bringing up the right photo like 9 out of 10 times. You can even search for specific items or frames in videos, but in my testing, searching through video frames is a bit hit and miss, so this feature still needs some improving. Next up is Picture Cleanup, which is basically Apple's version of an AI eraser. So let's bring up a photo here. And then by tapping the photo edit button, there's now a new cleanup feature right here. And I have to say, it's probably the fastest AI eraser I've used yet. So let's tap it. And now if we want to get rid of these hands here, let's circle them all. And you can see how fast it removes them live. It immediately removes them without any wait. It's honestly pretty good. This works on any photos in the library, and not just photos taken on the iPhone either. Next up is writing tools, and I've been using this far more than I would. When highlighting text across any sort of apps, like even in text messages, you can see that there's a new Apple Intelligence icon. Tap that, and you get a bunch of writing tools. You can proofread your text. You can even quickly rewrite the text to be more friendly or professional, for example. It will literally change it to sound more professional right there. And yeah, this is really nicely integrated, and it works quite quickly. It does a great job, and it's great to have local options to fix text up across any app that I'm using. You can even use it when reading an article like this, for example. You can highlight a big chunk of text and then click writing tools, and you can even summarize it by key points right here, and it will immediately do that pretty quickly, and you can share it with your friends, for example. Pro tip, if you want to summarize the entire article, you can just go all the way back up and tap reader, show reader, and then there is a summarize button here. It will summarize the entire article within seconds. There's also a bunch of smart tools when going through emails now, which are pretty useful in saving some time. The summarize feature is built right into the Mail app. So if you have an important and really long email, let's click into a random one here. If you pull up, there is a new summarize feature. Just click that, and it will summarize the email for you with one tap within a single paragraph. There are also full sentence smart replies for a one-tap response to emails that you've been sent, with different sort of contextual options based on what's actually in the email. So if I just tap a random option here, it will generate a full reply based on the context of the email. And there's other minor updated features like pushing time-sensitive messages right to the top of your inbox. These features definitely aren't game-changing or the first time we've ever seen this, but it is great that we have it implemented natively into the iOS ecosystem. Then there is the new memory movie features. We can basically create a highlight reel with just natural language. So let's give this a go. Let's just type in, for example, food trips in 2024. Click create. So yeah, it'll basically take data and photos and auto match them up with a song, and tapping the three dots at the top will allow you to control the movie, like adding certain photos or the length of the movie. It's a nice to have feature. It's great for retaining memories, but definitely not groundbreaking again. Before you do go on and update iOS and install Apple Intelligence onto your own iPhone, it is worth pointing out that Apple Intelligence does use your own personal data currently to help improve Apple Intelligence. So if you're worried about privacy, that's something that you're concerned of, this is something to be aware of. You can access and download all the data it's taking. Just go into settings and scroll down to privacy and security, and scroll all the way down to Apple Intelligence Report. And then from here, you can tap the export activity function and then get that full report. So there's still a lot of promised AI features that are yet to come, and unfortunately the biggest changes like Siri's on-screen awareness and personal context isn't coming until at least March next year. But as it is, Apple Intelligence definitely does add an extra layer of features and usability to an iPhone, and we should see this continue to improve and improve. If you made it to the very end of this video, drop the code word comment future and I'll give it a like. If you found this video useful, drop a like, subscribe for more, and if you're interested in my full review of the iPhone 16, I'll leave that video right here for you to check out. As always, thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next video.